with Andrew Worland this morning from International Graphite. Andrew, good morning.
Hi, Andrew. How are you?
Yeah, good, thank you. Good, Andrew. Look, big milestone here. International Graphite's been awarded $4.7 million in Australian federal government grant funding. Tell us a bit more about it and what it'll be put towards.
Yes, fantastic news that we announced today, Andrew, on the back of the Federal Minister King making a press release over in Canberra. Some 13 companies, I believe, were successful in tapping into a $50 million pool of funding, of which International Graphite was awarded 4.7. So nearly 10% of the funding was directed towards International Graphite's projects, which we think is fantastic. That funding will be used to advance the various aspects around the Springdale Graphite project down in the south of Western Australia, and also test work and development work in Collie for our battery anode facility that we released a scoping study on last month. So the timing of the news is fantastic for us. We're obviously thrilled that the federal government is stepping up to support critical industries. And of course, we're still in the pipeline for potential funding out of the Collie Transition Fund, which is a Western Australian-based fund. And news of that hopefully will become available in the next sort of 12 to 16 weeks. So a lot of support for International Graphite and what we're trying to do, so we're thrilled.
And just on Collie, in the last couple of days here, you've announced you've identified a site for the plant.
That's correct. We've been working hard on with various counterparties down in Collie, both private landowners and also government landowners, to find the best location for our proposed battery anode facility. We selected a site and narrowed in on a commercial arrangement with a private landowner over the last two or three months, and we're pleased to announce yesterday that we reached a set of terms, a memorandum of understanding that allow us to lease that land for a period of up to 40 years, which is just wonderful news for us. It really puts a nice degree of certainty around what we need in terms of infrastructure and services and so forth. And the big win for us is that it's right adjacent to the existing Blue Waters power station and all the transmission networks that are associated with that. So we'll be able to tap into, you know, the lowest cost possible power transmission that one can in the marketplace. And so we think that's an enormous competitive advantage for what we're trying to do at Collie vis-a-vis other potential plants in Australia and certainly overseas.
So, Andrew, what are you working on currently as far as Springdale and Collie? What's coming up in terms of news?
Yes, for Springdale, we're waiting on assays to come through from the completion of our drilling campaign that occurred in March of this year. We, just to refresh your listeners' memories, we drilled just over 20,000 metres of RC and diamond drilling over the past 12 months down at Springdale. We have a considerable amount of assays still in the labs, over 10,000 assays still in the lab. And so we're very much looking forward to receiving that data over the next 4 to 6 weeks. That'll then form part of a mineral resource update for the project and allow us to take us down the mine planning and optimization path as part of a pre-feasibility stage. The other part of the work at Springdale is about preparing bulk concentrates for mineralogical test work, and that feeds directly into what we're trying to do at the battery anode facility, because the concentrates that we'll produce down at Springdale will then be suitable for battery anode test work as well.
Good to speak, Andrew. Thanks for your time.
Thanks, Andrew. Great.